our naturopath from New Zealand. Thanks for coming back. Flaxseed. I've spoken many times about flaxseed. What's the benefits of flaxseed really for gut health? Are there any benefits for eating flaxseed? Well, there's tons of benefits for eating flaxseed. Flaxseed is a crop that's likely, probably the first crop ever grown. I mean, it goes back, the reports of, you know, if you go back 5,000-6,000 years ago, people were, you know, consuming flax. The Egyptians grew a lot of flax. They grew it, of course, you know, for cloth. They made linen, like flax linen out of this, out of the fiber out of it. So it was revered. Even the mummies, a lot of people actually were wrapped up in linen cloth. So, you know, it saw them through their life as well as their death. So it's amazing. Lots of people talk about the omega-3 content of flaxseed, when in fact it doesn't really contain omega-3. It contains alpha-linolenic acid, which is a precursor to omega-3. So it can get built into an omega-3 compound. But to do so, it has to work through a particular pathway where it will need vitamin B6 and it will need other, you know, nutrients to turn into an omega-6. So don't necessarily think it's an omega-3 supplement. But alpha-linolenic acid has many, many benefits for the body. Nevertheless, a lot of anti-inflammatory benefits in particular. But flax is a good source, flax seed, of calcium, magnesium, selenium, phosphorus, and various other minerals as well. And it also contains stuff called lignans, which is a kind of estrogen-mimicking compound. So it's used a lot also successfully for premenstrual syndrome and things like that. And for menopausal symptoms, it works well. Linseed sunflower almond, LSA, is a good mix. It's very good for the gut because it contains fiber. The key thing about flaxseed is the fiber content. So research, you can probably read some studies online, the mouse and rat studies, I believe, where they fed mice the fiber. And what they were quite surprised with was it had an interesting effect on preventing obesity. So the fiber does fill people up, but it also triggers various types of groups of bacteria, good bacteria, to grow in large amounts. And they confer a lot of benefit on the people, you know, the consumer. They even have appetite controlling kind of benefit about them. So yeah, I'm a big fan of flax. I think it should be part of everyone's diet. It can be used in a smoothie, the flaxseed. It can be, you can even make muffins. Check out the blueberry muffin recipe online. Blueberry, I think it's blueberry and flaxseed, a muffin recipe. It's got honey in it. It's an excellent recipe. It's got spelt flour in it. It's a really good one. But yeah, there are many, many ways you can consume the flax. The oil is, the linseed oil is a really nice oil to consume. It's a great one. I really like the taste of that. It's quite nice for sort of like really light or shallow sort of cooking. It's got a nice golden color and a beautiful taste. But if you've got constipation, this is the stuff to have. Flaxseed oil in your diet, or linseed, same. Flax and linseeds, the same thing. The oil, I would recommend you consume that regularly, and also the powder or the ground flaxseed. Fantastic for getting the bowel working really well. Good for bloating. Make sure you have plenty of water in your diet. But two or three tablespoons of the flax over a several month period, you watch what happens. You'll get incredible benefit from that. Thanks for tuning in.